So here's where we left off. I just kind of started working on the two-tone skin. Did a lot of work around the jaw. I didn't do the top of the head yet. That still needs to be like same kind of highlighted orange flesh. Just kind of basically put down where the highlights and shadows would be on the blue flesh. But, yeah, so we stopped on Friday, but right now, I'm going to start working on the tongue, and then we'll do the teeth and everything, and we'll get this in there. See how that goes. So for the tongue, I wanted to do more of a bright, like, pink. Kind of get it a little brighter than I would normally go. So it stands out a little more. So for the base coat, I use the Indian Shadow from Scale 75. Now I'm going to use some Carnal Pink from P3. First, I'm going to mix them together and then probably use this by itself. And then we have an even brighter highlight for later. And these little, like, spots will be an even different color. I'll also probably use some burgundy wine in here in the deep recesses. Alright. A little more over here. We can work that middle line back in. There is the start of our tongue. Alright. Go back to the Indian shadow and they're trying to... work the, crevices and stuff, get that color back in there. It's good that a little wet still from the carnal pink mixture. That way we can kind of blend this in a little more. I'll make sure we get into all these little grooves here. That was a mistake. And then we'll have to figure out where the light is coming from so we know which side of these grooves to highlight. Make them look nice and deep. Yeah, I'm gonna put my own grooves in here as well. Give the tongue a little more texture. Basically, just put in your own little lines and then you'll highlight them. And we'll get the shadows a little darker in there as well, and they'll just look like the same sculpted in texture that's already there. I'm taking some burgundy wine from Reaper and really thinning it down. Because it can be a bit strong. So now we gotta clean this up a little. Still need this middle line to be so thick. Kind of go over it a little bit. We can also thin out these lines as well. It also helps straighten them up a bit. Alright, next we're gonna get a brighter highlight. Which is White Flesh from Vallejo Nocturna. Hey Snickson, how you doing? Oh, that just kind of squirted out. All good, that's good to hear. Yeah, this was where I was at from the last stream. I gotta work on mostly the mouth today. Actually, I should probably use some of these before I do that highlight. I'm gonna use that first ton highlight and get this like flesh right here. It's going on a bit thick, and then I can go back over it with the Indian shadow. Alright. I'm gonna use this white flesh and highlight all these little grooves. I'm gonna go to the what will be the bottom side since it's sticking out like that. And it's fine to go on a little extra thick because you can just go back in with the last color and thin it up a bit. Go thick with those lines, that's fine. And after I get the ton all finished, I'm gonna work on the teeth and the claws and probably the horns, because they'll all be the same basic color. back to that last highlight color and thin down these highlights a bit. I'll go back to that carnal pink. We'll use that to highlight these tongue parts. Let's see, this will probably get a lot of the light right here. And then, of course, right here, sticking out like that. It's coming out of the mouth, kind of like that. Go a little bit over here as well. Try and blend that back in a little with the Indian shadow mixture. Some straight Indian shadow here. Try to clean up this center line a bit. We're gonna do these bubbles, or not bubbles, like boils or whatever on the tongue, a bit yellow. I'm gonna start with burnt orange from Reaper. The big thing is going to be spotting them all. Now that there's a bunch of paint on the tongue. Hopefully these big yellow blotches on his tongue look gross enough, because clearly this cave squig has eaten some things that gave him a disease. Alright, now we need to get a good shadow color for that. I'm gonna use some ruddy leather. Mix it up and see if this is a good shadow. With this, we just want to hit the bottom half of those boils. It's a little difficult to try to outline the rounded bit as well. Now, take some of that burnt orange and mix it with white flesh. Trying to get this highlight to blend in a little bit more here. That could use a little bit more on the tip of the tongue. Really trying to get a good blend going in here from the highlight to the base and the shadow. It needs one a little bit more of highlight, and then we can move on to the teeth. Alright, let's move on to the teeth, and then we can put the tongue into the mouth and see how that looks. And of course, for the teeth and the claws and stuff, I'm going to use good old forest skin. You want to make sure not to hit the flesh that we've already painted. The colors of the bumps or boils or whatever that I use for the tongue will be the same that I use on the flesh here. Probably stand out a little better on orange and blue flesh. Rather than a bright pink tongue. Freaking bubble in there. Kind of ruined that a bit, so I'll go back over that later. I'm gonna try and get the inside of these teeth. you can really see this very well, but it's just making sure even the inside has some coverage. Alright, I'll try to get the inside of the upper teeth. Probably won't be seen on camera very well. I apologize. I want to make sure there's full coverage here. That dries. We'll go back over to this fleshy bit here. Trying to redefine these striations, the soft tissue. Let's get right up to that tooth. Same over here. I also want to get a little color inside here. Not a whole lot of this will be seen though because of the tongue. But it's good to hit it just in case. Just kind of blend that back in. Alright, before we keep working on the teeth, I just want to hit the claws with that same base color. One foot, now the second. I'll probably do the horns in the same color as well. But I want the horns to be darker than the claws and teeth will be, so once I apply this, I can hit it with some probably Wildwood contrast paint. Go to the horns. So again, this will be a darker color once I get that contrast paint on there. All right, now we can start highlighting some teeth. So, what color will work? I guess we can just mix some white into the forest skin. See how that goes? Alright, so I got some of that burnt orange in there as well. And let's see. Let's see how this goes. Nice that these teeth have some nice, like, sharp edges to highlight them. Yeah, I think these bottom teeth are actually getting covered by the tongue when it's sticking out. While I'm highlighting, I also want to put in some shadow. I'm going to use that same ruddy brown from earlier. Kind of really thin it down, make it a glaze. Kind of get it at the base of the teeth as well, where they meet the gums. Probably, yeah, should have done this before starting the highlight, but whatever. Alright, and then use this on the inside as well. Yeah, a little more on the inside. I'll use that original forest skin. Kind of blend back in with that highlight, and then we'll get a much brighter highlight for the end. What I kind of want to do is finish these few teeth right here and put the ton in, and then we can see what teeth really need to be highlighted and where. Alright, I'm gonna get some glue and we're gonna put that ton in. Shouldn't take too long to fully dry and stick in there. Alright, we still actually need to get a little bit of that interior gum line, but also, when it's I'm done painting it, I'm gonna put in like saliva and stuff, and drips going. We got some edge highlights in there, and now we just go back and blend in some of that original color. The Loonboss riding on a giant cave squig? Yes, it is. I just really haven't started the Loonboss yet. He's right there. I hope to finish the cave squig by tomorrow, and then I can start working on the boss. We'll have plenty of non-metallic metal on him. Great design. Thank you. Can't take full credit. I'm kind of copying Richard Gray a bit. He had like a two-tone skin for the squig. Though I'm going more Hollywood movie poster of orange and blue. Try and blend some of that highlight back in. Don't want to go over too much of the teeth with this white highlight. New to mini painting and just got this as my first mini. Oh, really? Well, have fun with it. What brush are you using? I am using a Raphael 8408 size 1. The Kolinsky sable brush. I also really. The 8404s are what most miniature painters use for in the Raphael range. But I kind of like using the 8408s. As you can see, the tip is a little longer and thinner. So you get a little bit more of a nice, like, fine detail with just the tip. I kind of want to put a bit of a yellow tint to the top teeth. I don't know. So maybe I'll really thin down this burnt orange. Just kind of glaze on some of that color. I'll have to redo the shading and highlights as well. But that's fine. I just felt like it needed to be just a little bit different. And I'll go back with that shade color at the base of the teeth. Thanks for the follow, Ron. A little more of this shade down at the bottom here. Make sure that's all nice and dry. You say 8404? Yeah, this one I'm currently using is an 8408. But I use a lot of 8404s. From Raphael. Very good Kolinsky sable brushes. Nice natural hair fibers. I mean, if you're painting your first model, you don't really need these fancy brushes. I didn't get any of the sable hair brushes until after like a year of miniature painting or so. There's nothing too bad about synthetics. They just kind of don't last as long, even if you take care of them. But they're super cheap. There's some people, like I believe Sam Lenz, who paint, or at least I don't think he used to, paint all of his stuff with synthetic brushes, even things that he's won like Golden Demons and Crystal Brushes with. Buddy recommended I get Rosemary and Company, a UK brand. Yeah, they're pretty good. I mean, if you're in the UK, I would recommend getting those. They're not that not as expensive as brushes like these or Winsor & Newton, but just as good as quality. Honestly, even if you're in the US, I've ordered some Rosemary & Company brushes. Like, I got 3 Rosemary & Company brushes plus the shipping from the UK to the US, and that was cheaper than a single Winsor & Newton Series 7 brush. And then if you look at a lot of miniature specific brushes, like this is Broken Toad. You know, a miniature company who makes brushes. Same with Artist Opus and the Womp Forum. This is a miniature painting forum. Their brushes that are branded from them, I believe they all use Rosemary & Company to make those brushes. So those are still really good brushes. I'm gonna hit the horns right now with some contrast paint. Just to darken them up. I'm gonna use Wildwood. Thin that down. I ask how you blend between the colors. Yeah, sure. So, what I do is mostly layering and glazing. Like, there's people that will. I don't really do it often, and if I do, it's mostly because it's just kind of the paint's still on there and wet. But you can do wet blending where you have like wet paint. Show it over here more. Like, you put the paint on, and while it's still wet, you get another color, and you just kind of blend it in while they're both still wet. Like I said, I don't do that too often. What I like to do is either layering, where, I put like a base color down, then I'll put the highlight down, and you just kind of, in thin areas, just go over with the highlight, then you go back with the base, and you just kind of layer that in, or you glaze, where you get the paint on the palette and you thin it down. Like, you see right here, this is a big glob of paint straight from the bottle. Like, put it off to the side a little bit, get some water, and thin it down. And now you can see it's like really thin. So what you would do is you paint on your base color, then you thin the next color down, and then you would go over it in very small layers, wait for that to dry, do it again, and you can, like, let's say you're doing, like, I haven't done this part of the leg yet. So this is the base. So the next thing I can do for the glazing is I get the next highlight color, and I go over like 80% of it and do a couple layers of that, and then maybe make the highlight color just a little bit brighter, and then go over like 75% of it until you get to the final highlight. Those are the common ways to like blend in your paints. Make sure we don't touch the skin, even though I didn't really do the top of the head here. We get some dark color pooling in those recesses there. All right, let that dry. How do these teeth look here? Yeah, I feel the teeth are mostly okay. I am still not at all happy with this. So. Let's try to fix that before I do anything else. the shadow color back in there. Get rid of that cat hair on the brush. How's that looking? It's a little better. It'll work more on the inside of the mouth now that we have the tongue in there and we know where things are going. Probably try to hit some of these edges here. Right along this edge, darken this up a bit. Very thin. Ah. There we go. Let's try to blend this highlight in just a little bit. Fix this little shadow mistake that I made. There we go. That should be good. A little highlight right here. Alright. Because now I can start working on the claws. Actually, you know what? I want to put the contrast on the claws too. Darken them up. Just make them a little bit darker than the teeth. I want to make sure we cover the whole claw. That we don't have some egregious dry spots. I want to make sure that contrast is spread out evenly. You don't want pooling. One thing I'm gonna do here. See how this goes. This might ruin things, but who knows? I'm gonna get some pure white. Make it a final highlight on some of these teeth. Get it nice and bright. Get it very bright, way too bright than we want it, because I've decided I'm gonna put some contrast on the teeth as well. Let's see how that goes. I'm gonna use snake bite leather though, instead of wildwood, and that is the wrong color. There it is. Thin this out. There. I feel like maybe I should take those intro songs out of the playlist. Especially if I'm doing random. Here's another intro song. Random Playlist really likes to stack intro songs together. Alright. Definitely have to highlight this again. Maybe this didn't work out as well as I wanted. All right. I think it did help. It did kind of give that yellowish tint that I was hoping for. Burnt orange didn't really provide. All right. All right, there's still just a few spots on the teeth I want to highlight. Mostly on this side. All right. What I really want to do now are the eyes. Just don't like looking at those little black dots anymore. Gotta really mix up the paint that I'm gonna use to base it though, so give me 1 second here. I don't use this color very often, so it's kind of dried a little. Let's see. We should just that's fine. A little wet, but this is pale flesh. It's a great base for eyes because you don't want eyes like the you don't want the white of the eye to actually be white, because your final like sun reflection will be white and it'll just kind of blend in together, and it won't look as natural. So this is a little more like a grayer off-white. And like I said, it just works better than like a pure white. Need some black for the where the hell did my black go? There we go. Black will be outlining the iris and then obviously the pupil. Thin that down just a little bit. Okay. All right, this will basically cover everything we just painted, but you do want to leave some of that white showing. Alright. Focus a little here, and then you can see. Covered most of the white of the eye with the black, but we will go over that black with the color of the iris. Which, since he's orange-faced, again, I didn't do the top of the head yet. That'll be more orange. But even with the red, too, it'll stand out. I'm going to give him green eyes. So. Get... What is my brightest green? What is this? This is leaf green. I want viper green. Viper green from Reaper. Dry paint in the tip, so we got to get rid of that. Yep. All right. So now we basically just cover all the black we put down, but leaving a little bit of outline. We actually need two coats or so, just so we can get all the green in there. I also want this to be brighter. I'm probably going to mix it with some yellow and do this again. There and focus a little bit. You can see the green basically covered like 95% of that black I put down, but there's still just a thin line around the green. Some people like to put the iris down and then actually go in there and outline it with black, and I find this is just so much easier and less room for mistakes. I'm gonna mix a little yellow into this green and then probably a little white just to get it lighter, brighter. Now we'll put this on, see how it looks. Add in a lot more white and just try and get the bottom here a little bit All right. Now we get some black again, thin it down a little bit. And then with just the point of the brush, I'm gonna try and put on a pupil. Mess this up just a little bit. There we go. See it? Focus a little. So now I got a pupil in there. A final thing. Pure white. Again, with just the very point of the brush, we're going to put a light reflection from the sun. Kind of go side there, and then you go onto this side, same side. Put a white dot. There are its eyes. A little better look here. No. I don't really want to focus, huh? Yeah, he's got some green eyes. This white dot is a little too big, so take that pale flesh color. Go right around the edge here. Back over the eyeball. Lessened that white dot, and now it's a two different colors there. One last thing, I'm gonna get some thin down black here. I'm just trying to outline the eye, kind of black line it from the eyelid. Went on a bit thick, but it's fine because all that black went onto the flesh instead of the eyeball, which is easily covered over. When we go back to painting the skin. Not mean to hit the camera arm there. There we go. Now we kind of outline the eye a little better. Still cannot get a good. Here we go. Alright. I kind of want to cover this more. A little bit more visible now that it's in the mouth. Yeah, we're looking now. Alright. I think that's where I'm gonna stop for today. I might do the claws and the horns off stream. We'll follow the basic way I did the teeth. I mostly just wanted to get the tongue and the mouth and the eyes all done for today. Blend this in a little better. All right. Then at the end, when everything's all done, I can add in like saliva and have some like drool dripping from them. Tomorrow I will go back to the flesh here, hopefully finish it up. We still got the top of the head to do. I haven't really touched that at all. And then I'm not happy about this. For some reason I put a highlight on the bottom. Why, I don't know. So we'll just rework all of that. It'll be fine. There's still more work to do on the feet and everything. And of course the underbelly will be more of a white than a purple. But yeah. That is where I'll call it for today.